Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and today we are going to talk about how to use copyright match tool and how it can be beneficial for you to protect your YouTube videos. So let's get started. And first of all, when you upload or edit a video, let's say I am uploading this video, and along with the title, description, tag, thumbnails, category, playlist, audience type, and language and subtitle, if you scroll down, then you will also see this option here, license and distribution. And by default, the standard YouTube license is selected. And however, if you want to choose Creative Commons, then you can also do this. That way, another people can download and upload your video while attributing to you. But by default, the standard license type is selected. So if someone download and upload your content on their own channels, then you can use the copyright match tool to identify those uploaders or freeloaders. Those are people who just download other people's content and upload to their channels, and that way they are just replicating the content. So to stop this, YouTube have given us an opportunity to identify those freeloaders that you can easily do through copyright match tool. So before using this tool, you can also see these options when you edit this video under show more. If you scroll down, then you can see this license and distribution option. And if you have selected standard YouTube license for all of your videos, then you can use the copyright match tool. But before using this tool, I will advise you to first take under the consideration about these conditions that must match before you use this tool, otherwise it could be harmful for you as well. The copyright match tool is available for all YouTube creators who have above than 100k subscribers, whereas Content ID, which is only available for CMS, Content Management System, so you can use this tool if you have, or you will only see this option inside the Creator Studio if you have more than 100k subscriber. Beside that, you must also meet these conditions if you want to use this tool. I have given the link of this blog post in the video description. You can read more about that. But let me tell you a few more important things about the match tool before you go and use it. The first thing is, you should be the first person to upload the video, and YouTube will match the video according to the time, like who has uploaded the video first, you or the freeloader. He will identify that who is the owner or who is the freeloader according to the time of upload. So naturally, if a person is downloading and uploading and replicating the content, he will be the freeloader, because his time of upload will be far more greater than the original uploader. The next thing is, the creator can decide either he want to take an action or he just want to ignore that. So when you use the copyright match tool, then you have two options. You can either give the freeloader a 7-day time, or you can instantly give him a notification of copyright strike. So that's up to you. And you can not claim those content that you already uploaded from public domains. That means the content should be original and yours. And there are further few more conditions, like the video must have 25 views at least to be eligible for Content ID claim. And let's start with the copyright tool, and I will show you that how you can use it. So here I click on copyright tool, and before I get started with this, let me show you the removal request that I already made last week. So here you can see the channel name who uploaded this video, Creative Use of Blend Tool in CorelDRAW, and that is the channel name, and requested submitted on February 19, 2021, and request status is resolved, video removed. And it is obvious that he might have received a copyright strike on his channel. I go back to the matches, and here you can see a lot more videos of mine that has been re-uploaded on other channels. So currently we have more than 50 videos which has been re-uploaded on other channels. So I will give you two or three examples to show that how this tool works. So here we have this first video, how to hide Wi-Fi password in Windows, and it has been re-uploaded by Technology Tricks. And according to the copyright match tool, the content of the duplicate video match 100% to my video. That means he just downloaded and uploaded this video on his channel. So before you go and give him a removal request, you must look into the content first. So here is the video, and if I forward it in the time, and now I show you the original video by clicking on the following link. Let me skip this.
We are going to learn about how to hide the wireless security password from network properties window.
He has also removed the audio from the video.
How to find the lost Wi-Fi.
So if I now want to give him a request of removal, so what I can do, if you move here, then you will find three options. Either you can move this message to the archive, or you can request video removal, or you can also directly contact to the channel who has re-uploaded your video. So I don't want to contact him, I just want to send him a request to remove this video from his channel. So I will click this button, and here you can see the infringing video and my content. And here you need to fill out this form, and here you need to tell the relationship. Okay, now here you can give the secondary email address if you want to, and the default email address will automatically get filled here. So here you have two options: removable timing, either you want to give a 7-day time or notice to the freeloader, or you want to give a standard request removal now. So if you click on this, as I told you first, that you must use this tool very fairly and should use on the content you made for by yourself. So here I make a check mark on all the agreements, and here you need to type your signature and then click submit. If you want to submit more than one request in a time, then you can also use this tool from here, add a video, and then you can add the links of infringing video and your content, and that way you can add more than one request in a time. So let first submit this one. Copyright complaint submitted, and here if I go to the removal request, you can see it that it is under progress. So now move back to this tool again. As I told you before that you should use this tool very fairly. So here if I go down, then you can see this video, particular video, kinetic typographic text animation, and it has been uploaded by many channels. So I would like to tell you one thing about this. I had uploaded this video a few years back in 2016. So that is just a template, PowerPoint template, which can be used to make an intro of your channel. So I am giving this template for free to all the interested viewers. They can download this template from this link below and can then change this template with their username or channel name, and then can re-upload to their channel. So I am not going to make any removal request on these videos. So what I can do, I can just put them into the archive. So as I click on this button, the video will move to the archive folder. That means you want to ignore this particular videos from the copyright match tool. So that way you can submit as many requests you want, but you must use this tool very fairly. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.